test fitting the oil pump to make sure all the clearances are fine, making sure the pump does not hit the cam, making sure the pump gear fits all the way in. Go ahead and put it in. This, now it's in the cam, we'll turn it into the lock of the cam right now, and that's excellent right there. You can see the gear is flush with the case.
The pump body must not come into contact with the cam gear. Match the size and location of the oil galley holes in the case against the size and location of the pump body holes. The oil pump gear must not bottom out against the face of the cam gear. Oil pump size is determined by how tall the gears are. Make sure the four case studs match the pump holes.
This is for an earlier case right here, a single relief case. It's got a smaller oil hole, receiver hole right here. And it also has a bigger flange here. It sits at a different depth. It's used only on flat cams. This pump here is designed only for dual relief cases and uses a special dished cam. It sits much farther into the case, and because the camshaft is recessed, it allows for more gear clearance. This is another case, another pump used for a dual relief case, and it's used with a flat cam also. The gears are considerably smaller.
The gasket cincher glue that we're going to use for these mating surfaces will not adhere well to the oil. That's why I always keep it very clean. I spread this on both sides of the case till it becomes tacky, and then assemble the two case halves. Just cleaning out the base of the cam plug hole right here, cam plug groove. Here we go, snug in there. Glue it dry. Notice how the clips hold the lifters in place. Okay, go ahead and guide your case on the main studs, like so, and drop it. Just carefully push the case on. Do not drop it or slam it so nothing pops out. I'm not putting much pressure on each one, just trying to see it out.
Follow the case tightening sequence in your manual. Note that the Bentley book starts out with this small nut first.
Do the big ones. Reset the torque wrench for 26 foot-pounds. Beautiful. I don't put any pressure on the ones around the oil pump because the next procedure is going to be putting the oil pump in.
Use the thicker gasket here with sealer to prevent leaks.
It should be clicking. There it goes. When I sent away for the machine work, I also asked for a new pump cover. This is what I got. You can see how the back end is completely flattened out.
Use the super thin gasket here. If you add sealer, it will increase the distance between the pump cover and the gears, which will lower the oil pressure. Put some light grease on the gears to prime the pump.
These are sealing nuts used for the oil pump cover. Note there's no washer on the sealing nuts.
And the seal is face down.
We'll go ahead and test for rotation here. See how smooth everything rotates. This is almost perfect right here. Okay, there's very minor resistance. That's just because of the thickness of the oil in the assembly lube. Here we have the two pressure relief units. If you notice that the front one that will go in the deep hole here, it has a little step in it. That's the one we prefer to use up there. It's a little heavier duty. And also, it's very important how you put these in. You want to put this face down right here so the groove and the little head goes into the engine block first. The hollow spot.
This grooved piston should never be installed on a dual oil pressure relief case like you see here. We made a mistake, don't you do the same. Use the grooved piston only on a single relief case. Be sure and visually check the piston seat in the case for damage and wear before installing the piston. The piston and bore must be oiled before installation.
These little crushable O-rings. If you notice, the kit will only have one. You may have to reuse an old one or buy an extra one at the Volkswagen shop. Never put any glue on these gaskets. The reason being is they'll be very hard to take off if there's glue on when you change the oil. Okay, if you have a hard time slipping over the studs, take your sump plate and just push them down like so, flat. This here's the appropriate sump plate for the dual relief engine. It's got a slightly bigger hole than a single relief. Okay, again, if it's not seated, just like so. Again, put absolutely no gasket cinch on these.
Now it's time to set the end play. Your target end play will be 3 to 5 thousandths, which isn't much. First, you will have to install the flywheel and measure how much free play there is with no shims present. We will be using a dial indicator to measure the end play, but there is a cheap end play tool you can buy that works fine. For the best accuracy in setting end play, you must fully torque down the flywheel. You will probably have to use a long angle iron brace we talked about earlier. Note that with this brace, it is even possible to set the end play with just the flywheel and crank bolted together out of the case. The idea is to grab each side of the flywheel and pull it in and out evenly.
Get 35 right there. I'll bring it back down slowly. We're looking for 3 thousandths worth of shims here. Remember, we saw that dial indicator move 35 thousandths, and what we want is about 5 thousandths worth of end play. A little less is preferable, maybe anywhere between 3.5 to 5 thousandths is acceptable. So, here's a shim that's a 10. Another shim, that's a 9.
There were 31 thousandths, that gives us our play.
But first I have to push down and push back up. So, remember, you got the end play shims in there now. Everything's much tighter.
Now we will take off the flywheel to install the O-ring and main seal. The flywheel shims should be oiled by hand before installation. Be sure and use clean shims that have no rust. Make sure they all have the same hole size. Don't use warped or twisted shims. They must be perfectly flat. If it doesn't feel flat, don't use it.
If you notice on the inside of a 12-volt flywheel, you have a little groove. This is where a small O-ring will go into. Always oil up the O-ring first. The reason I oil this up is so when you put it on the end of the crankshaft, it doesn't pinch. Oil will let it slide over the crankshaft. It's right up in here. Like so. Here's what happens if the oil O-ring is not lubed up or put in the groove right. You can see how it pinched against the crankshaft previously. And what happened was the flywheel would chatter and would leak oil past this O-ring. Now we're going to go ahead and place the main seal into the rear of the engine.
First of all, put a little gasket cincher on the edge of the main seal. I'll set the main seal down. Let it just get sticky. Remember all the three.
Mike is using gasket cinch here because he believes in taking no chances when it comes to building leak-free engines. However, the rear main seal was designed to be installed with no sealant around the outside.
If you notice, I took out the dowel pins. The reason for this is that the tool I have is an economy type tool, and it's a big washer that basically presses in the seal using the gland nut. Okay. Now I'm going to get the seal started. First I'll push it in with my fingers. Okay, now we'll pick up this little tool. There's a much more sophisticated tool we can use. Also, if you don't have the tool, I'll show you how you can use a hammer and an old seal. Okay. Make sure you can start these by hand. Tight now. Let's go ahead and back it out. If you notice that the seal is actually recessed a little ways into the back of the case. This is a must, otherwise you will have an oil leak. The flywheel is designed to ride on the seal with the seal being recessed in a little ways. If you do not have a special tool to install the rear main seal, you can carefully use a hammer, a little rubber mallet or a brass hammer in this case, and what you want to do is tap the seal all the way around in until it's flush with the rear of the case. We try not to hit the back of the case, we don't want to mar the back of the case up. Then, to recess your seal, take an old main seal that you've taken from your old original motor, place it in here, and lightly tap around. This will allow you to give you a little area to strike, and the same token, it's the same circumference as the new seal. You'll be able to drive the seal into the case with the recess, like so. Carefully all the way around. Keep your strokes even. Here's the seal. Like so. This is not that, so we don't run the seal dry that way. Carefully place the flywheel in place. All four dowel pins are installed. Go ahead. Now, I'm just going to lightly torque down the gland nut. When we finish this project, we're going to go ahead and Loctite this in later and torque it all the way down with our 3-foot breaker bar. But it's very hard right now to hold this block down and use a 3-foot breaker bar on it without having the block flop all over the place. Nifty flywheel lock.